01 knapsack problem. Okay, the problem is that you have given n object and an knapsack of capacity m, and each object is having a weight wi and a profit pi is associated with it. Okay, so our objective is to fill the knapsack to maximum profit, but keep the total weight less than or equal to m, the capacity of knapsack. Okay, this problem is just like a fractional knapsack problem, but in fractional knapsack problem we can take a fraction of an item, but in the case of 01 knapsack problem you cannot take fraction of an item. Either you have to take all the entire available item or leave that item. Okay, so if you take an object I, a profit I will be earned. Okay, so our objective is to maximize sum of profit into fraction, but in this case xi will be 1 always, or it will be 0. Okay, and subject to the condition w into xi less than or equal to m. Here also xi will be either 1 or 0. Okay, I am just comparing it with the fractional knapsack problem. In fractional knapsack problem xi can be any value between 0 and 1. Xi can be 0 less than or equal to xi less than or equal to 1. This is the case of fractional knapsack problem. But in the case of 01 knapsack problem xi can be either 0 or 1. Okay, so first I will show the backtrack method to solve the problem, then after that in next lecture I will discuss the algorithm. Okay, so initially here we have 4 items and a knapsack capacity 16. Okay, and I have arranged the item according to their profit by weight value. Okay, it really doesn't matter in the backtracking algorithm, but in greedy algorithm you always have to arrange it in the profit by weight order, otherwise you will not get the optimal solution. Okay, so initially we are representing 2 values. The first value is profit and the second value is weight. Okay, initially our profit and weight both are 0. Okay, and let me add the first item x1. Okay, so that will be represented as edge of this graph. Okay, so when I add x1, that is set x1 is equal to 1, the entire available x1 will be added. Okay, so my profit will be 14 and weight of available x1 is 2. Okay, so my current weight is 40 and the current profit, sorry, current profit is 40 and now current weight is 2. Okay, and it is less than the size of knapsack. Okay, so I can add the next item x2. Okay, so if I set x2 is equal to 1, that means I am adding x2, then my profit becomes 40 plus 30 is 70 and total weight will become 2 plus 5, it is 7. Okay, so again my capacity is 16, so 9 more I can add. Okay, so if I am adding the third item x3, at that case available x3 is 10. Okay, so 10 plus 7, the weight will become 17, but our knapsack capacity is 16 only, so I cannot add x3, so I am killing this node. Okay, there is no point of exploring this node further. Okay, so I will backtrack from this point. Okay, I will come back here and I will set x3 is equal to 0. Okay, so before setting x3 is equal to 0, I will observe whether using the bounding function I will say, or I will observe that whether setting x3 is equal to 0 will yield a better profit or not. Okay, so for that I will use a bounding function. Okay, in that bounding function what I will do is that I have already included both the x1 and x2 into the next step, both I have set. Okay, now I am going to make x3 is equal to 0. I am not adding x3. Okay, next I have to add x4. Okay, so bounding function will calculate the, my profit, what the profit I will get if I exclude x3 and include x4 in the next step. Okay, so my current profit is 70. I am not including x3. Now available x4 is 5. Okay, and my knapsack capacity is 60 and the current capacity is 7. Okay, so 5 plus 7 is 12, so I can add the entire available x4. Okay, so I will add 5 units of x4, available 5 units of x4, and then my profit become 70 plus 10, that is equal to 80. Okay, so I will get a better profit. Okay, you will not understand this thing at this point. Okay, but when I will explain, when we set x2 is equal to 0, you will understand it clearly. Okay, so now I will set x3 is equal to 0. Okay, and So when I set x3 is equal to 0, again profit is 70, same itself, and weight is 7. And my expected gain is 80. I will get 80 if I proceed like this, okay, proceed further, okay. So then I set x4 is equal to 1, okay, and then my profit is 80 and my total Knapsack capacity is 12, okay. So I explored, I added or checked all the item, okay, I tried all the item and I didn't include x3, but I included x4. X1 and X2. So I finished here, okay, and I got a final profit, that is 80, okay. But 80 is not the optimal solution for this problem. I got a solution, that is 80, but 80 may not be the optimal solution for this problem, okay. So even though I got a value, then next what I will do is that I will backtrack it, okay. I will set a final profit here, 80, okay. Now you can see here I set x3 is equal to 0 and here x2 is equal to 1. I will try an option with x2 is equal to 0, and if I get a profit better than the final profit I set here, then I will explore that tree, okay, that side of the tree, okay. So if I set x4 equal to 0, my profit will be 70 only, and I think which is less than the final profit I already set, okay. So there is no need to explore this node further, so I will kill that node and backtrack, okay. I tried both possibilities here, x3 is equal to 1 and x3 is equal to 4. So I will backtrack from here also. And if I reach here, I didn't try the possibility x2 is equal to 0. Okay. So next time I will set x2 is equal to 0. And before further exploring, using the bounding function, I will check whether I will get a better profit than the profit I got already. Okay. So now at this situation, you can say x1 is equal to 1. Okay. I am setting x2 is equal to 0, okay. So my current profit will be 40, okay, and current weight is only 2, okay. So next, if I add x3 completely, all the available x3 is 10 unit of x3 is available, okay. So my profit, 50 profit is there, and weight is 10, okay, it is 12, okay. So for again space is there, so I will add x4. But x4 is 5, so if I add a 5 here, total weight will become 17, okay, but Knapsack capacity is only 16, so I cannot add that, okay. So here I will use the idea of fractional Knapsack, that is how much better profit I will get, okay. So what I will do is that I will take the fraction of x4, okay. Using that fractional Knapsack technique, I will calculate the maximum bounding value, that is the maximum profit I am going to get. Okay, and then I will proceed if that maximum profit value is greater than this value. Okay, so here I will take the 4/5 fraction of x4, because already our size is 12 and maximum capacity is 16. So 16 minus 12 is equal to 4 unit we can add. Okay, and 5 is available, so 4/5 of the item available. Okay, so if I add like that, my total profit will be, that is x1 is equal to 1, I will take like x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 0, x3 is equal to 1, and x4 is equal to 4/5, okay. In that case, profit will be 40 plus 50 plus 4/5 into 10, okay. That is total, I will get 98. Okay, so 98 is greater than the profit I have already got here. So I will explore this branch. Okay, that is, we are checking whether if I follow this branch or if I explore this subtree, whether I will get a better profit than or not. If I am not going to get a better profit, I will not explore it. Okay, that is how backtracking algorithm works. Okay, so when I set x2 is equal to 0, I am getting the profit 98 I will get, okay. So x2 is equal to 0, and now current profit is 40 and 20. Now I set x3 is equal to 1, so now my profit become 90 and current weight will become 12, okay. So if I set x4 is equal to 1, total weight will become 70, so I will not add x4, I will set x4 equal to 0, okay, and I got a better profit, that is 90, and this I will set as final profit, because the final profit I got here is less than the final profit I got in this portion. Okay, so this is then a current final profit. Okay, I hope you understood why I calculated this value here. Here the value expected profit is 98, but we calculated it in the fractional Knapsack manner. Okay, and so since I am getting the better profit than this one, I will explore this further in a 0-1 asset manner, and I got the profit 90. Okay. Now I will backtrack here and set x3 is equal to 0. When I set x3 is equal to 0, I am going to get the profit 50 only. Okay, that is less than my final profit. So I will not explore this node further, and I will backtrack from here. Okay, and here I tried two possibilities, and here next I will try the next possibility, that is x1 is equal to 0. Okay, so if I set x1 is equal to 0, that is x1 is equal to 0, then if I set x2 is equal to 1, my weight is 5. Okay, then x3 is equal to 1 means my weight will become 10. Okay, 10 plus 5, 15 is there. Now x4, I can take only 1 by 5th of x4. Okay, so if I take 1 by 5th of x4, my total profit will be 82. Okay, so this value is less than my final profit. The final profit I have computed here, that is 90. So there is no need to explore further this node, okay, because what is the projected profit is 82, which is less than the my current final profit. So there is no need to explore this node further, and we will stop the backtrack algorithm here. Okay, so the best solution for the answer for, or the optimal solution for this problem, is x1 is equal to 1, then x2 is equal to 0, then x3 is equal to 1, and x4 is equal to 0, and the profit you are going to get is 90. Okay, that is the answer to this 0-1 Knapsack problem. Okay, so this value is called a bounding value, and this we computed using the bounding function, and the bounding function will help us to predict whether we are getting better profit or not if we explore this node further. If we are not getting better profit than the already computed profit, we will not explore this node further. Okay, in the next lecture, I will explain this algorithm in detail.